I did a Pharmacy Today article about how you can use your students on rotation. So if you already have, you know, having students, that's another area that tends to get I wouldn't say it's ignored or anything. It's just, it hasn't been thought about in that way of, hey, you can use rotation students are coming to you. It doesn't have to be a one-way street. They can definitely help you as well. And so I've designed a few rotations where the students are part of Flip the Pharmacy and are giving back to Flip the Pharmacy. Josh, you're going to get another invite, like, probably tomorrow.
another student presentation.
Yeah. So it's, but how we use the students to benefit and help advance practice too. And they get a lot out of that. So, I mean, they do still obviously need to make sure that they're going to, you know, that their patient care skills are, you know, they're getting practice in that, obviously. But you don't have to kind of pigeonhole them per se. Like, I've had several conversations with some community pharmacies who are like, oh, I can have the student do that. I said, yes, your student can do that. So of just ways that they're like, I don't even know if point of care testing is for me. I said, well, give that as a project to your student. What are your barriers? What are things that make you nervous? Have them find the answers. Like, or go to that conference or sign into that webinar that you don't have time to sign into, have them do it and report back to you.
Yeah.
And they thought, this is amazing. So yeah, they're another great, great resource too.
Yeah. Think about all the research you get to do when someone else gets to do it for you, you know, like,
right.
Yeah. Well, you know, a lot of the times I'll use interns to do that.
Yeah.
There's another group I'm a part of called the Rural CP. It's the, it's a rural community pharmacy practice-based research network. It's in 5 states, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia, Arkansas, and Alabama. And then we're expanding to Tennessee and Georgia. Did I say Georgia? Anyway, we're expanding to them. But it's for rural community pharmacists. And that is exactly what you were saying, Mark, of the whole point of that is to write grants to get them money. So we can practice, show what's working in rural settings, and get the money for doing and helping us advance. Like, what, how do we address right now, kind of the things we have in the pipeline, or how do we address vaccine hesitancy in rural communities? And so we get the community pharmacies to partner with us to try the interventions and make that study. But then we also have the study. I mean, we're paying them for that too. So you don't have, it's a no cost, venture, but trying to set up more networks like that, I think that's kind of what, for me, CPESN is, to me, it's my laboratory per se, and that rural network is a laboratory that's actually has some really well experienced researchers that actually can get NIH grants, so we have a few of those in the line.
Nice.
But it's doing exactly what you're saying.